So this is a second vid for this example. It's quite a tricky example, really, because we've gone from, we've got three kind of cases, haven't we? Going from A to C around the edge, A to C across the middle, and then I run a bit of distance from A to B, and then leg it across the grass. So I've got to here now, I need to minimise this. So I'm going to minimise it, so it's dt by dx. So the x over 6 just becomes 1 over 6. Now then, this here is all chain rule. So the way I do chain rule, I'll just put the third down, is I differentiate inside the bracket. So that's going to be a minus 200 plus 2x. Then I put the power at the front, so that's a half. Then I multiply by the original bracket. But I take one off the power, so that's minus a half. Now that's not the best looking equation to be dealing with, is it really? I've got dt by dx, I've got 1/6, I've got plus 1/6. I'm just going to swap these two around inside the brackets. So I've got 2x minus 200, and then I've got 13600 minus 200x plus x squared, all to the power of minus a half. Now for my minimum, so I know it's going to be minimum, so I'm looking at a stationary point, dt by dx is 0. So remember for AQA, anything like this, you have to state it's dt by dx is 0, but then also you need to write it down with the equation equal to 0, just to be on the safe side. Now what's nice about this is that the completed pack, they just put it straight into solver on their calculator, so that's going to be equal to 0, isn't it? And the calculator solved it for them, and it gave an x value of 65.4 metres, so I leg it across here to 65.4 metres before I run across the grass. There. And it gave a time, if you sub that x value into t here, so I'm going to sub x is 60, was it 65.4? Yeah, 65.4 into there to get me a time. Gives me a time of 34.0 seconds. So I run 65.4 metres along the path from A to B, and then leg a straight direct path from that point straight across the grass there. Now it says about what modelling assumptions you've made. So if you think about in terms of assumptions, we're running at like a steady pace, aren't we? So it's almost as if we were at full speed as we hit A, and then when we change direction, we kind of instantaneously slowed down. Which isn't true, is it? Because you'd set off from A and you'd speed up, and then when you change direction at E, you would slow down and then speed up. So the path says, PAC says, assume the runner doesn't accelerate or decelerate. So we're looking at a steady pace, aren't we? There's no obstacles, no random dogs to chase after you and bite you. So you've got no obstacles to run around. Stuff like that. So that's that first little bit done. Okay? Right, see you later. Bye bye.